Week 9 of Aon's Public Affairs Podcast was recorded June 3rd, 2020.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. Week 9 Public Affairs Podcast. Daniel Sirota out of Chicago, Illinois. We are pivoting this week, and I am excited to be joined by Jill Dalton, Managing Director of Property Risk Consulting. Jill, welcome to the podcast.
Thank you, Daniel. Great to be here.
So, Jill, we pivoted for a reason. There's been a lot of topical things happening that has happened this weekend. There's things that are happening in the market that folks need to be watching for. One is hurricane coverage. And then two, I want to dig in the back end to talk about the civil unrest that has been happening across the country. But first, let's dig into hurricane. Why should folks be looking at this now? What is the importance of it?
Well, it's the start of hurricane season, officially June 1st. We, as of right now, we're doing this on June 3rd. There's a third named storm already in the Gulf of Mexico, which is the first time there's ever been three named storms this early in the season. So the predictors, those who make predictions about hurricanes, are saying that this is going to be an overly active hurricane season. That's why we're talking about it now.
And Jill, during this time of the pandemic, are we ready? Do you think that it's something that we are paying attention to, that the insurance industry is ready for overall?
Well, you know, luckily the insurance industry and the adjusters that we rely on and the people that we rely on to help businesses recover right away are deemed essential in all 50 states. So the people who go to the scene after a storm to take a look and do the damage assessment, they'll be able to get there, I'm pretty sure, but it'll be different because in some states, things are more open than in others. Like if it was to be in New York, it would be very different than if it's in Georgia. But, you know, they're essential. But we're worried about things like, will there be, you know, hotels open? Because typically the adjusters swoop in and they stay in the hotels and they do their work. But, you know, if hotels aren't open and if rental cars aren't available and if flights, there's hardly any flights anywhere. So it'll be slower. That's for sure, is the response and the process will for sure be slower. We're also concerned about contractors and that work. You know, if a lot of contractors probably went out of business, they lost their businesses maybe. So we're concerned about whether or not things will be able to get back up and running as quickly as we've come to expect.
And what is the role of Aon during these hurricane crises? So you talked about the hotels, the vendors, everything else. How are we playing a role in this?
You know, we have a rapid response service where we commit to being at a client site right away within 24 to 48 hours to the best of our ability. We get there and we immediately start to help them assess the loss and mitigate the loss and do what we can to get them back up and running, stabilize their facility. And then we also have claim prep accountants who immediately get to helping the clients start to measure their claims, telling them what information they need to collect, what invoices and setting up accounts to monitor their expenses and their lost revenues. And then, you know, also we help with negotiating with the insurance companies right away.
And overall, you know, is this a U.S. market only? Do we see there's some impact globally that hurricane coverage should be worried about during this time?
Oh, yeah. The brokers place our clients, you know, property programs with global markets. So it's global markets that participate on the programs that we are, you know, the brokers make the placements. We do the claims. It's global markets. And it's also a hurricane. It's typhoon or cyclone in other parts of the world that also impact our clients globally. And the only difference between a typhoon and a cyclone and a hurricane is which ocean it's in. It's really the same thing. It's just called something different depending on which ocean is impacted.
Helpful. And Jill, any state action that has taken fold? I'm assuming the state of Florida, you know, being part of the hurricanes in the past, have been and taking some sort of action. Have you seen anything on the ground there at all?
I haven't. I haven't seen it, but you know, I'm sure that the states that are in the hurricane path, they've really had to alter their response plans, because think about what normally happens is, you know, the cities and towns tell people to evacuate to shelters or hotels. And if hotels aren't open, and if they can't evacuate to, you know, think about a shelter, they can't, they want to practice social distancing. How are they going to do that in the middle of a pandemic? So I'm not aware of the details, but I'm sure that the states are thinking about that and how they're going to alter their emergency response plans based on the pandemic.
No, and that's helpful context. And I'm, you know, we could definitely be a resource for people moving forward in this. I couldn't agree more. There's a lot of at play with the pandemic and hurricane. How do states start to prepare and how do states start to budget, right? Because I think budgeting is a big part of this as well, of making sure the dollars are there for folks to being able to set up more shelters, set up more opportunities for people to be able to have the cover needed moving forward.
Yeah, and I guess a lot of states have their budget is June 30th. So I think that'll this could definitely, you know, be different because of the pandemic. And pandemic and a hurricane at the same time.
Well, that was extremely helpful. And thanks, Jill, for that. And Jill, I want to kind of pivot now.
Again?
A very topical thing that has been taking hold across the United States and more broadly the world. There's been a lot of rioting, looting, protesting. How does insurance play a role during this time?
Again, insurance plays a really important role because it helps get the businesses back up and running as quickly as possible. You know, when these types of events, civil unrest, riots, the damage that gets caused is generally covered under most property policies. So our clients are going to rely on their insurance to help reimburse them to make the repairs that they need and to reimburse them for their business interruption, the loss as a result of the physical damage or the curfew civil authority that get enacted because of the physical damage that could be caused as a result of the rioting and the looting.
And, you know, if you're a small business owner, Jill, like what extent of coverage do you have, right? Is that something that you kind of hinted, you know, the high level of P&C is covered through it. Is there anything else people should know about that?
No, it's, you know, it should be something that is in their business owner's policy. You know, how much coverage they have depends on what kind of limits they buy and what kind of deductibles their individual decisions were. Hopefully they have the coverage for it. It's different than flood, right? Because flood is kind of an optional coverage. And a lot of businesses don't, when a hurricane happens, a lot of businesses, small businesses don't have flood coverage. But in most cases, I think they will have coverage for this.
And what is the impact on something like this, in your perspective, to the insurance industry as a whole?
Well, I think this is another blow to the insurance industry, which has been hammered with losses, you know, a lot of property claims since Harvey, Irma, Maria, Hurricane Michael, Hurricane Dorian, a lot of big fire losses around the country, around the world, attritional losses. So this is another big blow. And COVID-19 losses, you know, all the event cancellation coverage, the insurance markets are really getting hit badly with a lot of events happening around the globe. And this is just another one.
So Jill, how would a civil unrest BI claim be impacted through pandemic?
Well, Daniel, that's a really good question. And a lot will depend on what's the state of the business during the pandemic. If it was a business that was completely closed already because of the pandemic, and then they had property damage resulting business interruption, the insurers are going to say, well, you're not having a business interruption because you were closed anyway. But there will be the time and space element of these claims will be important because maybe a store just reopened this week. And then the next day they had the damage. So it'll all depend on forecasts and accounting and what was, because, you know, we typically use historical, what would have happened in the past when we're doing BI claims. That process is not going to be used, especially for the businesses that were already closed or already operating at much lower levels than they would have been normally. So it's going to be really different doing BI claims as a result of the damage that might have happened because of a riot, but the business was operating completely differently because of the pandemic.
Yeah, and I will also add, which you brought up a really good point on the hurricane side of this conversation, is the adjusters are going to be extremely busy. you think about what has happened across the country, and now that we're closely approaching hurricane coverage, you know, it's going to be a busy time for the adjusters on travel and being able to do all this work moving forward.
Yeah, it's for sure. You know, the resources will be stretched thin if there's a lot of work going on with all these civil unrest claims. And then if there are a lot of hurricanes, you know, the adjuster community is really resilient. We saw after Harvey, Irma, Maria, we definitely saw some challenges in terms of responsiveness. But it all got done. It just got done a little more slowly.
Absolutely. And I saw in Mayor Lightfoot's address in Chicago, this was a big emphasis to get adjusters out there quicker. And I think we will definitely see, but I agree with you. Very resilient and very much out there to get the job done.
And there's a lot of new technology that Aon is using and the adjusters are using with apps to take pictures of the damage. And we have our own damage assessment app that we typically use it with our consultants, but we're looking into ways to give that app to the client so they can take the pictures, answer the questions, use that technology to get the information immediately to the insurance companies so that they have the information to start figuring it out.
I love it. Well, Jill, thank you so much for joining the podcast. I hope you will be coming again soon, and always appreciate your insights into what's happening. And thank you again for your leadership.
Daniel, thanks for including me. It's great to be here.
And next week, week 10, we're going to be joined by Aon's CEO of Commercial Risk and Health, Lori Golterman from Chicago. Stay tuned, and thank you all for joining the podcast.
This information is a resource for Aon clients and business partners. It is intended to provide general guidance of potential exposures and is not intended to provide legal, regulatory, or medical advice. Due to the dynamic nature of infectious diseases, Aon cannot be held liable for the guidance provided. We encourage listeners to seek additional information from credible sources. Thank you.